Basically step on the scale, and you know, he came in at a good weight with his clothes on. I'm gonna stop here.
Yes, I'm ready. We're here with Deontay Wilder. Everything you did in this camp was with a purpose. What was the intent of bulking up to the heaviest of your career at 238 pounds?
Well, you know, the weight just came on, you know, just I wanted to look sexy and feel sexy. I taste sexy as well. You know, I'm bench pressing over a little over 350, so whatever weight come in, I can lay on my back and lift him. So it won't be none of that, you know, rushing me and putting all this weight on me and different things like that. But most of all, man, we just wanted to have fun in camp. It was a joyful camp. It was a loving camp. And we had a lot of great time, you know what I mean? The time that was given, you know, it was advantage for us to be able to train and to make things, they say we practice for perfect, and some would say you practice for permanent, and that's what we did.
There's a stillness about you. You mentioned the word calm. How important is calm in getting a victory over Tyson Fury on Saturday night?
Calmness is the key to the storm. You know, I know that when I'm not calm, my mind is cloudy. So when your mind is cloudy, it allows you to make bad decisions. But when you're calm, you can weather the storm. When you're calm, you're able to see certain things and you're able to decide, make great decisions. And I'm looking to be calm this fight so I can make the great decision, so I can show the people what I'm all about. We have rejuvenated myself. We reinvented myself. Redemption is upon us. And I can't wait to show the world what I'm all about. I'm reintroducing myself to the world as Deontay Wilder.
Thank you very much. We're all looking forward to that fight. Now I walk over to Tyson Fury, the third BBC heavyweight champion of the world. Tyson, you're both the heaviest that you've ever weighed. He answered what it meant for him to be this heavy. What does it mean for you to be this heavy on Saturday night?
It means total obliteration of Adolfo. Total annihilation. That's what it means to me. 277 pounds. I'm going to pull him in the Royal Infirmary after this fight. Don't worry about that.
Now, you changed drastically for the rematch with Sugar Hill Stewart in your corner. What kind of changes and improvements do you expect in Deontay now that he's got Malik Scott in his corner?
Nothing. It's one shithouse teaching another shithouse how to fight. Both a pack of losers, and the both ain't worth a sausage. So he couldn't teach him anything. Man couldn't fight himself, he was a shithouse. So when you got shithouse teaching another shithouse how to fight, you're in for a real pack of shithouse cowards. Look at the state of him. His heart's rattling now. His balls have sunk up inside of him. There's a man here that's going to annihilate your daughter. Me, the Gypsy King. Tyson Fury's name. And fucking fighting's the game. Ain't a man born from his brother's cunt can beat the Gypsy King. Never mind a sausage like that there.
Well, we apologize for the language, but for the rematch, you predicted exactly what would happen against Deontay. And Tyson, just the final question. How do you envision this trilogy ending?
With him severely hurt on the floor, smashed to bits. Looks like he's been run over by an 18-wheeler truck. He was complaining last time he had a cracked skull and an injured arm. Oh, I can't wait for Saturday night. I'm going to really severely damage him. He'd be unrecognisable after the fight. His little pretty wife down there will not recognise him. Don't worry about that. I'll send him home butchered, like a butcher's block.
All right, thank you very much. Well, we've heard from Tyson Fury, Deontay Wilder. I can't wait. Kate, I'm sure you can't either.
I guess no face-off then, guys. Will there be a face-off or not? Take your shirt off.
Get you.
They're gonna face off with the big separation. If they're facing off with security commissioners and everything.
Pero a ver, ya se pusieron los dos, quiere decir que se hizo con distancia de báscula, pero no descartemos cómo se le hizo a otro. Todo puede pasar, ¿no?
Ahora vamos a ver si hay frente a cara a cara, face to face, el equipo de Tyson Fury metiendo con todo al equipo de Wilder. Créanme que no dudaría.
So there you have it, another great video for ESNEWS. For ESNEWSReporting.com, I'm Elie Seckbach, reporting, and you can follow me on Twitter, at Seckbach. And you can follow me on Instagram, at Elie Seckbach.